I'd now like to talk about hemiacetals and acetals, hemiketals and ketals. All right, the names of these species that we're talking about all depend upon what they're made from. For example, aldehydes will give hemiacetals and acetals. Now, a hemiacetal is a compound where we have taken an aldehyde and added just one equivalent of an alcohol group. What this leads to is a compound that has an OH and an O with some kind of alkyl group attached to the same carbon atom. And this is called a hemiacetal. An acetal will end up having two O alkyl groups attached to the same carbon atom. The prefix hemi means half, like the word hemisphere, for example. So aldehydes will give hemiacetals with one equivalent of alcohol, and acetals with excess equivalents of alcohol. Ketones will give hemiketals with one equivalent of alcohol, and ketals with two equivalents of alcohol. So aldehydes eventually give acetals, ketones eventually give ketals. All right, what we're going to look at first is hemiacetal and hemiketal formation. So we're just looking at the addition of one equivalent of alcohol. Let's look at the mechanisms that we can use to form those. All right, so here is our hemiacetal, hemiketal formation. And in each case, we're using 1 mole of alcohol. So for the acidic one, we've got an H plus. The first step always seems to be the H plus attacking the C double bond O. That leaves a positive charge on the C. Then we can have the nucleophilic alcohol come in to attack that positive charge. And then we can have the H plus leave, and that gives us our hemiketal product in this case. The reason I know this is a hemiketal is because we started with a ketone. Had we started with an aldehyde, it'd be a hemiacetal. All right, let's look at the basic version. And it will attack the C double bond O. And the electrons jump up on the C double bond O there, onto the O. And then we will have the O negative take a hydrogen off the methanol. And that gives us our hemiketal product as well.